Greetings. As I mentioned in part one, someone from Islam asked a really good question. How and where do you learn to worship God? I finished up part one with the following summary. These are the first steps you need to really grasp. God is. God sent the prophets, and their message cannot be corrupted. No doubt all in Islam would agree with 1 and 2, but they would probably not agree with 3. Well, since making that statement, the brother in Islam who asked the first questions followed up with this gem. These men brought messages. Both of us agree on that. And these messages are from God. Both of us agree on that. You and I both believe there are prophets, and they exist throughout time to deliver the message to mankind. What is your definition of knowing a message is truly from God and not edited by man? I hope you recognize that this brother, just as I stated, readily accepts points 1 and 2. God exists, and God has sent the prophets as messengers. And I really need to take a moment to scold myself in public. And if this applies to you, allow God to correct you so you don't have to scold yourself in public. Never grow weary explaining the truth in love, Texas. Don't you ever give up on those who follow Muhammad. Don't you quit. Don't you dare get angry. God didn't give up on you. Don't you dare give up on others. Okay, God, I will not grow weary in well-doing. I have been bought with a price, and it is no longer I that live, but Christ that lives in me. And I pray that those watching will be encouraged as well. You see, those who follow Islam are largely seeking to walk the right path to God. And they cannot help it that they have been taken in by a man claiming his path is the right one. Then think about this brother's question and the heart that asks it. What is your definition of knowing a message is truly from God and not edited by man? The question comes from several concerns planted in his mind by his religion. First, Muhammad said his religion was direct from Allah. His argument is it was not edited and was therefore safer than any message that could have been edited. Notice could have been, not was, because Muhammad never offered evidence or proof of any change. But even this unsubstantiated claim is very heavy in the minds of those trained in this thinking. Second, Muhammad's claim attempted to one-up God's revelation through the prophets. The Quran is claimed to literally be word for word the syllables that Allah himself uttered and wrote. That claim also creates a huge barrier to anyone questioning the contents of the Quran. If it is Allah's very own words, you cannot question it. So if you can imagine and put yourself in the shoes of a Mohammedan, it is very nearly impossible for you to allow yourself to even mentally consider the possibility that it is all completely a fraud. Every fact you know and every idea you have must fit under the control of the Quran, must submit to Allah's words. So please love them even when they reject you and hate you. What is your definition of knowing a message is truly from God and not edited by man? And if you call yourself Muslim, this is something you must listen to and understand. You have come to the entire crux of your decision as a human being, brother. Your decision in this life is whether you want to follow a religion because it sounds good, or because it is from God Himself and is His approved way to approach Him. I'm trying to think of a definition that all mankind could apply, brother. Nothing about my own personal experiences, healings, or miracles. My personal definition must rely upon what God has revealed and endorsed, certified, empowered, and proven. 2. I would first of all decide that whatever measure or analysis or critique I was going to apply against one religion, I would consistently and evenly apply exactly the same way to the other. This is the only way to apply even-handed judgment in an objective way, not subject to assumptions, bias, training, or prior commitment. Since you follow the Quran and I follow the Bible, let's limit the analysis to those two, because they both make absolute claims of exclusivity. Both cannot be right. And then, my friend, you come down to your basic assumptions, which you have been told and taught and forced to accept into your thinking, so that they are the very foundation of the way your mind works. And for all in Islam, the absolute foundation upon which their thinking and analysis stands is that the Quran is Allah's very words. They are perfect and cannot be questioned. You cannot accept and hold that assumption and be objective in your analysis or your thinking, brother. But that is where the objective way to decide between the two rests. If you accept that God exists, and you accept that God sent the prophets, we have to rationally consider how we determine which religion is true and from God. And I think that if you are willing to apply the same standard and the same logic to both, the answer between the two will be very clear. I think it is important to begin this analysis in the next video. I have already done a series comparing Christianity and Islam. That's a good place to start to see what each religion says about itself. May the God who has revealed Himself to man by the prophets open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, who was revealed by the prophets, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.